Naveen Kumar from our preventive cancer care management. Now we are going to what you call understand what are the major killers. Cancer is one of the major killers along with heart attack and diabetes. These three diseases cover almost about 70% of the major killers, not only in Malaysia, but all over the world. Now I'm going to ask what you call Naveen, what are the preventive measures that you will advise in public or for the community?
Thank you, Ananda. It's a pleasure being here with you today. As far as cancer prevention is concerned, it's a very broad-based subject. But there are a few things. There are a few things that we can do within ourselves. Mainly, change of diets. We need to change our diet. We need to look into refined processed food, how much we consume and how much we need to cut it out. And we also need to look into something called the ketogenic diet. And the next thing is also probably have a diet full with fruits and vegetables. Now that's considered very healthy for the body and it does reduce the risk of getting cancer.
Would you suggest that what you call going more on the meat-based diet as compared to plant-based diet, which would you suggest or what would be the proportions or percentages?
I would suggest an organic plant-based diet, probably 70% and 20%, 10 to 20% of meat and 10% of carbs.
So that would be a good healthy diet?
Exactly.
Okay. The other thing, Naveen, that if you know that a lot of what you call people would be interested in complementary integrated medicine, especially for those who would not be keen to go for chemotherapy. What is your opinion and what are you doing on your immunology for the, what you call this cancer care management?
Okay, I do have patients who come to me after being diagnosed with cancer and they don't want to do chemotherapy. Basically, I would assess the situation and ask them why, what's the reason for not doing chemotherapy. A lot of people have got a negative perception just because chemotherapy did not work for their friends and they would feel that it may not work on them as well. But that's a negative mindset, so I would correct that. And I would also suggest that chances are it's better to seek a second opinion with another oncologist to review their condition one more time. And if after doing so, they are still not interested in chemotherapy, then I would suggest that they go for scientific-based treatments in the management of cancer. One of it is autologous immunotherapy. That's a very science-based treatment in controlling the cancer, reducing the cancer, controlling the cancer spread, and improving your overall immune system. Other than that, I would also suggest treatments, safe treatments, any kind of herbal medication, or any medication that you want to take from outside, it has to be safe for the liver and the kidneys. That would be my advice.
Okay. And you've been doing quite a bit on this alternative integrated therapies?
Yes. For more than 5 years, we have been treating cancer patients in Malaysia. We combine our immunotherapy with chemotherapy for some patients. Some patients, it's just standalone immunotherapy, especially when they have failed chemotherapy and radiotherapy and they do not have any other options, then at that point chemotherapy would be good. But then again, we need to assess the situation and to ensure that their organs are not failing. As long as their liver is not failing, we do have a chance in managing them with immunotherapy.
Okay, Naveen, I think that was a wonderful what you call a little discussion on cancer care management. And I really thank you. Thank you for having me.
Thank you very much.